Yeah, same clear message, even when the scoreboard doesn't go our way. Really thankful and appreciative of the crowd. You know, one of the best crowds in college basketball tonight. We've worked really hard to build this in our first season. And, you know, we had a nice home winning streak November and December and January. Our fans were great to us. And now the question, you know what, let's respond. Let's, can't wait to get back here and play again, put a better effort out there for the fans. But thank you for coming to the game. Obviously, really wanted to win this game today for so many reasons. You can feel the momentum building here as we build the program. So today would have been a nice one for the next step, but it just didn't go our way. Give Auburn all the credit. When you shoot the ball like that on the road, you're going to have a chance to beat anybody. I thought the tougher, better conditioned team won the game in the second half. We played really well in the first half in a lot of ways to be up 9. We gave up a 3 at the end of the first half, which was a misassignment. So really, we could have been up 12 at half. Then the second half, just different side of the coin. They were the tougher team, definitely a better conditioned team in the second half. So we take responsibility for that. You know, no excuse program. We didn't play well today, especially in the second half.
Questions for Coach? Just kind of talking about that second half. Did a really good job early on, just stopping Rome in the paint, and then he finishes with 15 in the second half. What was just kind of the challenge of guarding him? Or I mean.
Yeah, he played like a veteran. You could tell he wasn't going to let his first half affect his second half, which is a common trait of a really good player, a future pro. You know, to put one possession behind, let's win the next one. So I was really impressed with his poise and leadership today. He's one of the better players in the SEC for a reason. And I would say that about all their guys. They played great in the second half.
What did you tell your guys kind of after this one when you saw them after the game wrapped up, and what's the message?
Yeah, same message after every game. You know, let's hydrate, take care of your bodies tonight. We're back to work tomorrow. So obviously a different feeling in the locker room after a win or a loss. But same message. It's a long season.
Was it injury related to Bob Sharp when wasn't able to go?
Yeah, Sharp, we obviously missed him tonight, no doubt about it, especially playing Auburn. An opponent that we needed, that another big. So, again, it's not an excuse. Auburn beats us tonight, no matter who we have playing, the way they played in the second half. But Books wasn't able to play tonight. It's an illness, not an injury. And so at this point, he's kind of, you know, day-to-day.
Chris, just as a whole, defensively, you know, the game against Auburn, in Auburn probably, you know, not great defensively either. What are some of the commonalities that you saw in this game?
Well, the first common thing is Auburn. And so, you know, they played really well. Thought they were composed. They were very aggressive in the second half. You're going to look at this box score and you're going to look at the threes. They had a special night shooting the ball. But, you know, if you're going to win, you have to win in different ways. And so as obvious as the three-point defense was tonight, I thought the key was they were just driving the ball. They were getting paint touch after paint touch. Our on-ball defense was not where it needs to be in the second half. Our rim protection and help wasn't where it needed to be. And then, you know, in our drops, our rotation. So, you know, defense, you have different layers of defense. It starts on ball. Then it's the first help guy, the rim protection, everybody drops. It's a rotational game. And tonight there was possessions where we just failed on the first line, first insurance policy, second insurance policy. So again, give Auburn credit. I thought they were very aggressive offensively. We just didn't play Ole Miss defense in the second half. We had breakdowns at every level of our defense.
And how many of those defensive discrepancies in the second half come from losing the rebounding battle?
Yeah, it doesn't help for sure. I think a lot of that, you know, when you get beat driving the ball to the basket and you're in rotations, it puts a lot of pressure on your rebounding. So there was a lot of just simple missed blockouts tonight. There was many rotational. And I thought there were just some competitive plays. You know, the tougher team and the better conditioned team won the second half. I think you could say the same thing about us in the first half. Now, we played really well in the first half in a lot of ways. Second half, there's not much to talk about, and you guys saw it.
When you say better conditioned team, what are you kind of referring to? I guess how come February, how is that something they can improve on?
Yeah, exactly. I thought we looked physically tired at times, and I thought the mental toughness wasn't there. You know, when you play this game, there's going to be some times where you're physically fatigued, and that's where mental toughness kicks in. I did not like our mental toughness tonight in a lot of areas, one area being – you know, when we get fatigued, we got guys at the scores table, we can't just stop the game. And so I thought we had multiple players tonight just take plays off when they appeared to be physically tired.
Coach, how can you kind of like maybe address that in practice to maybe fix it, you know, moving forward to make sure that doesn't happen?
Yeah, right back to the process. You know, it doesn't change when you win, when you run out of time, which we didn't do tonight. We got beat. You know, right back to the process. It's a long season. We just got to get back to practice tomorrow. We got to address it. Got to have some man-to-man, you know, conversations, eye-to-eye. And we have to hold ourselves accountable, myself included. Tried to help the guys out in the second half, and the things we were trying obviously didn't work. So the Ole Miss players didn't get beat tonight. The Ole Miss organization got beat tonight, and our coaching staff is certainly a part of that, myself included.
You guys dominated the turnover battle in the first half, but were turning over twice as many times as Auburn in the second half. Do you attribute that lack of mental toughness to that beat?
I thought the guys pressed a little bit. You know, when you're up 9, we took their first couple of shots, and that's where a championship team's got to buckle down. You can't let the last 4 minutes affect this 4 minutes, and I thought we did that tonight. I didn't think that was Ole Miss basketball out there tonight for a lot of segments. We just got to play a lot better. But again, I'm not up here telling you it was all about us. Auburn played great tonight. It's one of the best teams in the SEC, which means they're one of the best teams in the country. I thought they really responded in the second half.
Any more questions for Coach? Thanks, y'all.
Thank you.